Hey guys, and welcome to another video. In the last episode, we worked on this dome thing over there, and we also looked at the spawn house, I think? Maybe not, I don't know. So last episode, I know for sure we worked on the dome thing. Get out of here, squid. And we also... What do we do? Oh, I got a present from Generic B. And if you haven't seen my mini-sode, Hermitcraft mini-sode number... 4 or 5, I don't know, whatever it is, it'll be linked in the description. You should check that out. And so the last episode we were working on this. Let me actually go into my options. Someone told me that there was a way to turn off the text, but it doesn't look like there is. I was talking about this text that pops up when you switch weapons. Someone said there was a way to turn it off, but I don't see any new options here, so I'm just going to assume that they don't know what they're talking about. So let's go ahead and head over to the this thingamajigger over here and take a look at what I finished. I've got torches throughout the whole bottom of it. I've got a bunch of chests full of sand. Ridiculous number of chests full of sand. Every single one of these except for this one is completely full. And this one's got a little bit of glass in it, but here we are. We are halfway done with this dome, basically. So what I want to do is I want to start moving things into here. Now, I was thinking about it, and I want to get my animals in here, but then it's going to take a long time to do that. I'm either going to make, like, a path that goes, you know, to my base from here, or I'm going to have to figure out some other way of getting them in here. I was thinking of making a nether portal in here, like digging down into the ground, putting it in the ground, and making one in here, but I'm not quite sure if that's what I want to do. I really want to plan this area out before I start building in it. I don't want to just start building things and then have to change them later. I do think I am going to bring the floor down like 3 or 4 levels from where it's at now, because the roof seems kind of close, like in comparison to the width of this. Like if you look, the roof seems really close in comparison, so I think I would like it to be a little bit deeper, so I'll probably end up doing that. We might even use an underground tunnel from here to that base, because there is a large underground area between us, so not too sure. I haven't decided on it, but either way. One of the things, too, that I was going to probably do is replace some of this dirt with glowstone and then delete the rest of it, but I haven't quite decided... what I want to do specifically with it. So for now, if I could get a torch on there, basically you can see how much lighter that looks compared to the other side. I want to do something like that, and then this sand is all temporary, so it's not that big of a deal. But I haven't got too much planned for this episode, really. So one of the things that I did want to do is go take a look at our spawn house, or my spawn house, or yeah, most of the people said I should call it my base, so I'll try to remember that. And go take a look at the spawn house and kind of decide what to do with it. I want to expand it. I want it to be bigger than it is now. It's too small, and yeah, I don't really like that. So I'll probably bring some materials with me, head over there, update it a little bit, and then go from there. So I'll bring a bunch of wood like I did last time, or saplings rather, and then I'll cut down a bunch of trees while I'm over there. And I also will bring some bones. Got a few of those, I think. And where are they? I think I put them up here. Or somewhere. Oh, here they are. Yeah, bunch of bones. I'll bring a bunch of bones with me. And yeah, so I'll see you guys when I get to spawn. Before I go, I thought I should mention, I didn't do any work on the basement. I realized a big flaw in my idea, and that is the fact that slimes are going to spawn inside this room here. Because of the one level floor, like this one block space will actually spawn slime. So I have to figure out some way of blocking that. So just thought I'd mention that. What the hell? Hang on. Oh, okay, they're above me. I'm like, what the hell? Yeah, there's chickens up there. I also turned up my game audio. Hopefully it's not too loud. I know a lot of people complained that they couldn't hear the game sounds and that I should turn them up, so I went ahead and did that. So let me know what you think, if it's too loud. I only have it at like 30% or something, so. So yeah, let me know what you think, and anyway, I'll see you when I get to spawn. Alright, so here we are at spawn. Now, in order to do what I want to do, I'm going to need a fair bit of wood. So I'm going to go ahead and cut down some trees for a little while, and then when I'm done with that, I'll be right back. Alright, so I've gathered a bit of wood. I have a little bit of excess stuff on my inventory that I might as well get rid of. And so we're going to work on the house a little bit. Now, the first thing that I want to do, somebody suggested that I remove these here and replace them with the actual spruce wood. And I think that's a wonderful idea. I think that'll make it look a lot better. So thank you for that, whoever it was that suggested that. Yeah, that looks way better. So I'm going to go ahead and do that for all of these. And then we're going to go downstairs, which there is not a downstairs right now, but there's about to become one. Because I decided that in order to make this house nicer, it needs a downstairs area down below here, because it just looks weird down here. So what I'm going to do is gather those saplings real quick and head over here. And so what I want to do is I want to put the staircase here. So I think what I'm going to do is break open that chest and... Oh boy. I guess this one's a bit full, isn't it? Let's see what we can fit in here. Nothing. Awesome. Okay, well, either way, not a big deal. We can always throw down another chest later, but for now, we're going to go ahead and just break open the floor here. Because I'm pretty sure this is where I want to put the staircase, so we're going to do it real simple-like. Whoops. Whoa. Okay, so we're going to do regular stairs here. So let's see if we can grab... I don't know what color I want to do them. I'm thinking I want to do them the darker wood, or maybe I can use the bricks. No, I can't. That's not enough bricks to make. Oh, yeah, there is. There's plenty here. Okay, so I'll make some stairs out of the bricks. Let's do that many stairs. Hopefully is enough. So they're going to go like this. Oops. And then the bottom floor will be, I think, at this level. And, of course, we're going to make a wall here and all that. So, let's see. Let us see. Not sure what I want to make the floor out of. I'm thinking I might make it out of the stone bricks. I don't have any on me. I might have to go grab some. But, oh no, I do have some. Okay. So let's go ahead and try this out. Because I think stone bricks would look good for the floor down here. Not sure where that glowstone came from. Let's see, do I want to do it down? I think I want to do it at this level here. So let's go ahead and do that and shovel the rest of this out. Oh man, I'm making a mess here. So let's see, what else? I guess we're going to have to shovel the whole thing out anyway, so not a big deal. Let's go ahead and do this though. And basically, I'm doing it out to the underside of this balcony here, because I think that'll make it look a little bit interesting, but I guess we're going to find out. I'm not sure what's down there. I don't think I'm even going to bother going down there. I know Joe got down there and he got a little bit stuck, so I'm just like, nope, don't want to deal with that. But anyway, I'm going to go ahead and finish up this floor and I'll be right back. All right, so I've got a little bit of this area down here hollowed out and flattened out, and let's go look at it real quick from over here, because there is going to be like an actual floor there, and I kind of want to see what I might want to do with it. So let's look at it from this angle here. You can see I use the half slabs there. I can't zoom in. I'm trying to use my Optifine zoom, but Optifine is not installed on the snapshot. What snapshot are we on? Hang on, let's 12W30A. Oh crap. I know the pre-release came out today or yesterday, so hopefully we'll update to the pre-release, because Optifine, I believe, works on the pre-release, which is awesome. Those guys update that so fast. Yeah, let's hop over here. I think this is the only side I didn't do the little half slabs on, so I'm going to do them there. But I did the half slabs to make the thing look a little bit more like it was suspended by these things. I think I might actually change that upper deck there to be half slabs as well, because I really like the look of it. And so anyway, what we're going to do is, let me just grab these half slabs. I'm about to forget. I almost walked right away from these two here, which need to be switched. Yeah, you can see that they're all half slabs on the edge there. I think it makes the house look like it's actually supported rather than having beams run through it for no apparent reason. Now I'm not sure for this corner I'm probably going to make it go out, and then for this corner here you can see it's kind of weird. Like I think what I want to do is just make the wall follow this path here rather than go out. And I think I might make like a little patio area here or something, that would go kind of up this hill and kind of lead up to, the road that's right here. I think I might extend the road kind of down or something, to where it's like I've got a little back door, back patio or something. Not sure. Still trying to think about that. But yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and get started on the walls, and I think I'm gonna use the same sort of style where I use the regular wood for the walls and all that. And yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that, and I'll be right back. All right, so I got a little bit of work done. Still trying to figure out what I want to do with these stairs. I don't really like them being brick now that I've put brick there. So what I think I'm gonna do is let's try this out real quick, because the way the brick looks from the side is weird. It's not too bad like when you're standing on them or whatever, but when you look at it from the side, it just looks strange. So let's go ahead and try out the stone brick and see how that looks. All right, and let's take a look from over here. Yeah, I think that fits a lot better. So I think I'm going to change all the stairs to that. So I'll just keep that noted for now. What I do want to show you, is what it looks like from out here. So let's head out here. Hopefully we don't get attacked, but it is what it is. Should be all right. Let's just check real quick. Yep. So this is what I've got so far. Now one of the things that I'm going to change for sure is that post right there, that middle one, is going to go all the way up and stop right where it's already stopped. Same thing on the other side, and then I've got two doors. I've got this one here. I added the little roof there. I think that looks really good. It's got the little brick roof, and then this one's inset, so it goes actually into the structure of the house, so that way it's not completely even on both sides. But it should get the job done. So let's go ahead and take a look in here. So you can see this one's into the house, and then this one goes out, and it's got the little brick roof. I'm wondering if I should throw a half slab in there. I don't have any on me. I might end up doing that. And then down here, if I ever decide to like expand downward, this is where I'll do it because that's underground there. And then I'm gonna have stairs that lead up here to the walking path, like I mentioned before. And should be pretty simple. And so I'm excited. Whoa, check you out. You are so fancy. See that guy? Hey, did that just bounce off of you, really? All right. Let's go get this guy. I want to see if I can get his armor that he's got on. Come here, dude. Ow. Oh, just a bone. All right. Wow, that's deep down there. Jeez. I didn't even realize how deep that was. All right, but yeah, the other problem that I see with this house is this overhang here. It still looks a little bit strange to me. It's not too big of a deal, but it's definitely strange. So I'm thinking of changing that a little bit. I'm not quite sure. I really do like how it is inside, but on the outside it looks really weird. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and make the changes that I said and then throw some glass in here. And I'm pretty sure that's all I wanted to do. So anyway, I'll see you guys in just a minute. All right, so I finished up what I was doing. I have to turn the sound off because the freaking rain. Finished it up. I got the glass in. I've got the doors in. Now, I didn't do anything on this side. I do plan on doing something there, but not today. I got these stairs done. They've got a little path, a little bit of grass right there. Let's head up here. I moved the chests or the crafting table to here and left the chests where they were at. I think they work well there. And that's about it. Yeah, this path goes down into the bottom floor there, and there we go. I made this little house-looking thing here, and I was spying on Unhost, but he seems to have disappeared. He was standing right here. Not sure where he's building at. I guess he's building a spawn house, but not quite sure where. He's been running back and forth all over the place. So I guess we're gonna find out when he does a stream or releases a video, so you should check that out. Welcome Unhost to the server. But yeah, other than that, I don't really have anything else to show you guys. Next episode, we'll probably work on the dome. But yeah, anyway, I want to thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, go ahead and leave a rating. And until next time, I will see you guys later.